David Schenker, thank you so much for taking the time to join us. We appreciate it. Of course, you have an overview here of these Israeli-Lebanon maritime border negotiations, a former point man at the State Department for just that initiative during the Trump administration. Based on reports that you've heard, based on what we know is in the public domain, what do you think about this emerging deal at this point?
Well, I think that Lebanon is going to be very pleased. There had been an area of dispute between the one line and the 23 line. It appears that Israel has agreed to the 23 line, so that's 100% basically of what the Lebanese demand was, plus a negotiation on Kana Field. What Israel gets is a buffer zone for 7 kilometers out and maybe a little bit of peace of mind, taking away one area of contention between Hezbollah and Israel. But I think overall it's pretty good for Lebanon here.
So you're saying Israel got the short end of the stick?
Well, I think the most important thing apparently for this government or caretaker government in Israel right now was solving one of its border disputes with Lebanon. And if that was the priority, Israel has plenty of energy. But, whether this will make a difference in terms of stability, either in the economic zone or on the blue line, I think that that remains to be seen. It's perhaps unlikely.
We had spoken many times in the time of the Abraham Accords when these peace agreements or normalization agreements were coming about. And I believe I had asked you at one point, the negotiations with Lebanon were going on at the time, and I kind of asked you, where would a potential maritime border arrangement fit within the greater context of finding a longer-term peace in the region? Looking at it now, with 2 years of hindsight and knowing what you know now about the deal that's being proposed, is this some sort of advancement in your eyes toward a more stable region, or... Mm-hmm. Is it simply a matter of we got to see if Hezbollah is going to hold up their end of the bargain?
Yeah, I don't think we can make a whole lot out of this here. It takes, once again, another point of contention, off the agenda. This does nothing to alleviate tensions along the blue line where Hezbollah is digging in, establishing more of these green without borders sites, putting commandos on the border, developing it with great speed, its precision guided munitions project. I think this does nothing to alleviate those tensions. It does and will be, a big deal in a way because there's not an agreement with Lebanon, but this is not, and Lebanon will not say that this is an agreement between Israel and Lebanon. This is an agreement between the United States and Lebanon and the United States and Israel, right? Whether they sign on the same piece of paper, whether they show up in the same room and have a signing ceremony, these things aren't clear to me. I don't think this does a whole lot for improving the atmospherics. I think the chances for Israel-Hezbollah war remain as great, if not immediate, because of the pumping from Quraysh. They still remain, I think, very high.
So when you talk about the U.S. serving as a broker here, typically when there's a broker, there's a broker's fee of some kind. Somebody gets some benefit out of the deal. What's the U.S.'s benefit in brokering this agreement? What does it get out of it short-term and long-term?
Well, I think it's a rare foreign policy win for the Biden administration. It is something that they can point to as being a success, as trying to calm things down in the region. Especially now that the Houthi ceasefire has crumbled, et cetera, so they can point to this as a foreign policy victory. It's not going to have great implications, for gas in the short term going to Europe. You might get some LNG coming out of Quraysh through Egypt that goes to Europe to help alleviate some of the shortages in the winter, but you're not going to get anything out of the ground. No molecules will be coming out of Lebanese fields for 5 years at least. I think it must be said, even for the Lebanese, who argued or negotiated so hard to get Kana Field There are no known reserves there. So we'll see if they get anything out of that. But no, there's no broker's fee for the United States. We are, you know, our mediator, we're you know, an altruistic power. And if Israel, you know, wanted us and saw it in their interest to broker a deal, then we, you know, the United States would be involved. And that's exactly why I moved forward with this when I was in the U.S. government, because our partners, our close allies, Israel, were interested in making progress on this.
That brings me to my last question, because former Prime Minister Netanyahu, now the opposition leader, said privately, according to reports, he believes that the U.S. is essentially committing election interference by pushing this thing over the finish line so close to an election. Is that in any way, in your opinion, a fair assessment?
Well, listen, I'm no Israel constitutional specialist or a specialist in Israeli elections. You know, I think it's for Israel to determine whether this is a type of territorial concession that would require Knesset approval or some sort of vote to determine whether this can go through, whether it's appropriate that a caretaker government, the lead up of elections, can make these decisions. That's not for, you know, the United States to weigh in on. I think there are reasons why both governments, as I said earlier, want to do this in the short term. But, you know, these countries, Israel and Lebanon, to a lesser extent, have their own rules that they're going to have to run the traps on. So, yeah, I'm not going to get into, you know, whether this is an electoral violation or not. You know, I think the United States, even the Biden administration, is doing this out of a desire to help the region and stabilize the region. And it's unclear whether that will be the outcome, but that's the place that they're in when they're trying to negotiate this.
Once a diplomat, always a diplomat. David Schenker, former Assistant Secretary of State for Near Eastern Affairs, now a senior fellow at the Washington Institute, director of the Arab Politics Program there. Thanks so much for your time and your insight. We really do appreciate it.
Good talking to you.